Help! I've fallen and I can't get up. That's what's happened to Workhorse and Hyliion Stock. They are in need of one of those life alert necklaces. When you fall down, you press it and the ambulance comes and scoops you up and helps you out and helps you get back on your feet. Hyliion Stock and Workhorse Stock have had a very bad last couple of weeks. Hyliion dropping from 58 plus back down to $18 a share. Workhorse was trading above $30. Now it's trading around $15. So what in the world is going on? Well, in today's video, we're gonna break down Workhorse Stock. We're gonna talk about whether it is a buy at these levels. Should we be buying the dip or adding to our current position? We're also gonna break down Hyliion Stock and go over the same things. Is it a buy at these levels? Should we be buying at 18 or adding to our current positions? We're gonna do a full depth analysis into Workhorse, the USPS. Do I think they're gonna get the USPS contract? Why do I believe it's still a buy at these levels? Same with Hyliion. So as always, let's secure the bag by making smart investments in sound trades. Let's get it. All right, all my trader and investor homies, let's talk about Workhorse and Hyliion Stock. They have been dropping like a rock. They've been crashing. They need to press the life alert button because they've fallen and they have yet to get back up. But in today's video, we're going to be talking about Workhorse, whether it's a buy at these levels where it's trading at now around $15 a share. We're going to be talking about Hyliion and talking about whether it's a buy where it's trading at around $18 per share. So let's jump right into it. Check out the link in the description after the video's over if you want not one, not two, but three free stocks valued up to $1,600. You have a chance to get a free stock of Google, Starbucks, Facebook. It's a great deal. All you have to do is click the link in the description, sign up with Webull, and deposit $100 or more, and you get three free stocks valued up to $1,600. So check that out after the video. All right, guys, let's break down Workhorse first. And then we'll talk about Hyliion after we break down Workhorse. So it's not been a good couple of weeks for the Stallion. That's a fact. We were trading up near $31 per share. And over the last couple of weeks, we have given back 50% off of the highs. And now we're trading around $15 a share. What has caused the drop? And do I think this is a good buy at these levels right now? I think the majority of the drop in Workhorse has been caused by executives diluting the stock. They've been selling a lot of shares, and I don't think there's any reason for this. I don't think they believe that they're not gonna get the USPS contract. I don't think they see a bleak future for Workhorse. I just believe they're taking some profit off the table. These guys had cost bases of nothing, $2, $3, $1, $16, $7, $6. They're just paying themselves. The way this works is executives are often paid in stock options, and if they hit certain requirements, they get those stock options that they can exercise at extremely low prices, and then they sell them because they want to get paid. Don't look too much into it. If you look too much into it, you start thinking, oh, these guys think they're not going to get the USPS contract or something like that, and I don't see that at all. I think they still get the USPS contract. I just believe that these guys, they're paying themselves. They want to be secure financially, and they deserve that. They put a lot of work in, and this is just a short-term dilution due to these executives selling some of their stock that they got via options. We have also had a bunch of pundits like Jim Cramer coming in and talking about Workhorse. Cramer came out the other day, last Thursday, and he called Workhorse a show horse or a show pony, something like that. And I really don't pay attention to what Cramer says because he's typically wrong more than he's right. And I still think Workhorse has a very bright future. Do I think it is a buy at these levels? Absolutely. But it depends on the type of trader or investor you are. Are you a swing trader? If that's the case, I still think it's a buy. I think this is a nice swing trade off of this level right here. You have a pivot here right under $13 a share. You also have the 200 EMA coming in, and I think it's a swing trade buy, and I think it's a long-term investment buy. People say, well, oh, it's off the highs by 50%, it's pulled back by more than 50%. Let's take a quick look at something. I wanna show you guys something. Let's pull up the Amazon chart real quick, and let's run it out. way back, okay? So Amazon made a nice run up way back in the day when it was in its infancy, like Workhorse is in its infancy, okay? So it ran up to $104 a share. It then pulled back all the way down to under $5 per share. So people are out there saying, oh, good companies don't have crashes like this. That is absolutely not true. Amazon gave back almost 80% of the stock price at one point. How about Apple? Apple at one point was trading at $8 and it pulled back to under $3 a share. This happens when companies are in their infancy. Why? Because they don't have any revenue to show. Workhorse is still a baby. It's still a little baby in the cradle, and it needs to grow up to become the stallion that we all know it is. But I hate to break it to you, it's gonna be a while before they start producing revenue. It's going to be a minute before they start putting out orders and getting those beating earnings expectations, and it may be a while before we get that extreme recovery. But I expect the Workhorse stock in 5 years to look very similar to that Amazon chart that we just looked at and to this Apple chart that we're looking at right now. Sure, there's a blip right now. We are having a blip. We had a pretty significant drop. But look at this Apple chart. You had a drop right there, big drop. Big drop right there. I know this drop right here doesn't look that big on Apple's chart, but that's from like 25 back down to under $10. So that's more than a 50% drop on Apple. So this kind of thing happens, and it is normal for a company that doesn't have much revenue yet, that's still a company that's just born. It just is still in the womb and is about to come get squirted out of the mommy's tummy. That's what Workhorse is, but we see the future. I still think Workhorse gets the USPS contract. I know I say this in every Workhorse video, but they're hiring all the other companies. Ford is firing. Those are the two big competitors in the contract. They just got added to the GSA website. They're based in the United States, and I guarantee you this contract is going to a US company, and they just got that $200 million in funding from a big institutional lender. That lender is basically saying that they have faith in Workhorse. And even if they don't get the contract, I still love Workhorse long term, because Workhorse is going to be that player in the last mile delivery game when states start to require reduced carbon emissions for their big four fleets. Fleets are gonna have to step down these carbon emissions, and I think Workhorse is gonna fill that void. Also, something that I think has gone highly under the radar regarding Workhorse is this Metron. It's the software as a service that I think Workhorse is gonna try to sell as a monthly subscription, and you guys know I love software as a service. The Metron is basically you can track your fleet, and it's gonna be able to allow delivery companies to become more efficient. They can track their fleet and then manage the routes via this Metron software. And I think this is gonna provide Workhorse with some reoccurring revenue. And I think this software as a service has really gone under the radar. So to conclude the portion of the video on Workhorse, absolutely, I think it's a buy at these levels. Yes, I think it's a buy. Okay, at $15 a share, I never thought I would see this level hit again. And I'm looking at this as an adding opportunity. All right, that's wrapping up Workhorse. Let's move on to Hyliion. Hyliion has not been any prettier than Workhorse has been. It has hit highs of 58, almost 59, and it has fallen off the cliff and is now trading at around $19 per share. So do I think Hyliion is a buy at these levels? Abso-freaking-lutely I do. Why do I think it's a buy at these levels? Well, let's talk about it. Number one, they really don't have any competition, right? The trucking industry, I've said it 1,000 times, I'll say it 1,000 more times, the trucking industry is not ready for total EV. They're ready for a hybrid powertrain, yes. And that is going to allow Hyliion to get a competitive advantage against its competitors. They are not ready for total EV. I just don't think investors realize this, and as it drops, I see it as a buying opportunity. Every dollar drops, I see that as a add. I love looking at price to sales ratios to when I'm analyzing growth stocks. Right now, Hyliion has a market cap of just over $3 billion. We're expecting revenue growth out off the charts, okay? And by 2024, they're expected to have over $2 billion in revenue. I think they crushed those revenue expectations. And that gives us a price to sales ratio of just over 1, and that is just too cheap. And I think they beat those expectations because I think that it is going to be way easier that for the, I believe it is going to be way easier for Hyliion to sell these hybrid powertrains to trucking fleets than they realize, than investors realize, because this is just going to be a path for truckers, trucking fleets, independent operators, to reduce their fuel costs, to become compliant with these states such as New York and California that are imposing requirements to reduce carbon emissions. So I see these earnings numbers getting absolutely smashed by Hyliion. Why has Hyliion been dropping like a rock? Because of the ownership structure. A lot of people who owned pre-merger are taking profit, and you can't blame them either. They are making a lot of money. They're taking some profit off the table. It's not good for investors. We've seen a significant drop, but that's what's happening. It's unfortunate, but it's going to turn around. But I hate to say it, it may not happen immediately because there's not going to be any revenue coming in the next few earnings reports. And what moves stocks is revenue, revenue growth, and news. So unless we see Hyliion come out with new partners or new production models, something big on the news front, then I don't see this stopping anytime soon from an organic standpoint. But long term, I don't think it matters, and this company is going to be just fine. At $18 a share, this is an all green lights buy in my book. I was buying at 25, and of course I'm going to be buying at 18. The moral of the story is, don't throw all your darts at the dartboard at the same time, right? If you loaded the boat up here at 45 and didn't save any capital in your account to add down here, then that's just a lesson learned. What I like to do is I like to take my positions in fourths. Sometimes I miss out on an opportunity when the stock just continues to go up, but that prevents you from getting stuck in something like we've seen in Hyliion and Workhorse. Try to take your position in either fourths or thirds, and that will save you a lot of money in the long run. For example, if you wanted to buy this initial drop at 45, you could have bought a third there. It continued to drop, you buy a third at 35, and then you buy a third at 25. You're still gonna be down big, but it's gonna prevent you losses from loading the boat at 50, and then you're down, your account's blown up. So that's just some food for thought. But companies that are the biggest tech companies out there have seen huge crashes. Amazon, Netflix, Tesla, Apple. They, in their infancy, when they first started out, they saw huge crashes in their stock price as well. It sucks to be in it. I know it hurts, but it happens. You just have to be, if you believe in the company, you just have to have faith in it if you're a long-term investor. If you're a swing trader, respect your stop loss and have a plan. I cannot reiterate enough how important having a plan is, because if you're a swing trader buying, say you like this consolidation, you thought it was gonna hold that level and break out, that area should have been your stop loss right there. And if you don't respect that stop loss and it drops on you, whose fault is it? Just use it as a learning experience, and hope you guys got something from the video. If you did, please consider subscribing and hitting the like button. It tells YouTube that these videos do contain value and it helps to promote my channel. Also, check out the link for the three free stocks from Webull valued up to $1,600 when you use my link. All right, guys. So I know it sucks. The other, all EV has been really weak. Look at Lordstown Motors. It is the worst. Lordstown Motors has dropped from 31 to 13. It's worse than Workhorse, worse than Hyliion. Look at even Tesla. Hasn't been strong, right? It hasn't crashed like the smaller EV companies, the startup EV companies, but it hasn't been strong either. So it's just a period of time in the EV sector that we're just seeing a little bit of a pullback, and we'll be all right. All right, guys, I'll catch you all in the next one. Until next time, peace, all my homies. Peace.